Anonymous. It's no secret anymore that the US and UK governments are prosecuting several people that helped Anonymous in our previous anti-censorship efforts, namely our retaliation to PayPal, MasterCard and Visa that was started in response to them terminating services to WikiLeaks. 40 people from US have been apprehended and questioned by the FBI and later subpoenaed. 5 UK-based Anons were also questioned, but we have yet to hear from them for any details. For now, we know what the US government plans to do. And we will act upon that. The fact that the US Anons are to appear before a grand jury points to the fact that the US government has no idea how to handle this new form of protest. These are the requests from the grand jury. Any and all records, documents and materials that relate to the internet activist groups 4chan and Anonymous. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to malicious software, code, or other programs associated with Trojans, botnets, denial of service attacks, to include but not limited to low orbit ion cannon and or high orbit ion cannon. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to interactions between any computers of those who were aided, and those who are untouchable. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to the identification and locations of persons using or controlling or disseminating denial of service software. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to administration, maintenance, operation, use, or propagation of the denial of service tools, including but not limited to low orbit ion cannon and or high orbit ion cannon. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to the identification and location of other computers comprising part of the denial of service attack onto a botnet. Any and all computer logs maintained in relation to computers found at home of the people raided. Any and all records, documents, and materials that relate to names, handles, email accounts or IP addresses of the occupants of the AnonOps IRC network. It is evident from these bullet points and the very nature of grand juries that the government has no idea how to handle this, nor does it have any idea of the tools we were using, that is completely lacking technical knowledge of them. The DDoS attacks we carried out work in essentially the same way an internet browser does, simply utilizing what is open to anyone on the internet. Also, they are likely to overlook the fact that the TCP/IP protocol was invented in the 70s and is now essentially an outdated infrastructure, allowing for these kinds of attacks to be carried out trivially. For example, the same kind of attack that LOIC does can be carried out using just an out-of-the-box Windows operating system with no additional tools. None of the people apprehended by the police were involved in any hacks, defacing or any other kinds of intrusions to private computer networks. These attacks were public, open to anyone, and advertised as such, as their very purpose is to attract attention, to protest. We're all aware that we have started a new form of protest, a so-called digital sit-in. It's now time to defend this new and evidently efficient form of protest, as people all over the world have done before with other ways of protest. Not only do we want you to join a physical protest, we need your help, specifically the help of those familiar with law practice, to help defend our fellow Anons in any way they can. This is what we ask from the FBI and police. That they stop raiding houses and seizing private property such as computers, phones, storage media and other electronic devices, and to stop subpoenaing protesters. That all property that was seized or subpoenaed in these raids is returned to the owners. That the current subpoenas issued to Anons are rendered invalid. This will be an ARL protest that is set to occur at the following places and times. We want you to appear at these locations at the specified times, wearing Anonymous masks, to show support for our Anon friends. United States District Court, United States Courthouse, 280 South 1st Street, San Jose, California, 95113, February 10, 2011, 9:30 a.m. New York protests have also been announced. Also, a major protest is planned for April 7, on the steps of the City Hall with speakers from Anonymous, Executive Director of National Lawyers Guild, Greg Hausch, Barry Eisler, Glenn Greenwald, Eric Brown and other special guests. Don't miss it.